Masami Isoda, Professor of Mathematics Education, University of Tsukuba. It is a good opportunity for me to have the lecture in SEAMEO QITEP about mathematical thinking, how to develop it in the classroom. And my lectures are related with the book of mathematical thinking, which was published year 2012 from World Scientific. However, main content, if you want to know the major discussion, please see the book itself. Okay, and at first, I would like to confirm the issues of education, objective of the education. If you open your national curriculum document, you can find your similar term, similar sentence in your curriculum. In Japan, developing children who learn mathematics by and for themselves, this is a major objective of the education. Okay. And this term, this similar term, you can find your curriculum, because this, I believe that this objective is general issues in the world. And we have this idea from the 1989 curriculum. And our mathematical thinking, the idea of mathematical thinking is written from the age of 1958 curriculum. Okay, okay, you know this drawing, this painting. This is wall painting in Vatican. It was written 1950. No, sorry. It was written 16th century, 500 years ago. This drawing was written 16th century, 500 years ago. And if you saw this picture, he is Platon and he is Aristoteles. And the original, these pictures are called Scholars of Athens. And this picture itself is written by Raphael. Raphael is here. And all people are discussion. And discussing the nature of the academies, and at the same time, the base of academy is mathematics. This is the base floor. And he is the Pythagoras, and he is the Euclid. So this drawing explaining that mathematics is the base of the discussion and communication, okay? Academic discussion and communication. Okay, and I enlarged the part of Pythagoras. Okay, this picture was written, drawn 500 years ago. Okay, what they are doing? They are communicating mathematics. And they are learning, studying mathematics. And only Pythagoras showed that construction. And she is explaining her finding. Okay. This is a real image of the classroom 500 years ago. How about your class? Is that the same? If it is the same, it is fine. However, if it is different, why you are teaching mathematics different way? Okay, is there any objective? What is the difference? And this is a really drawing about learning by themselves. We want to develop the student who study math like this. Teachers are thinking something, and he or she is talking about their finding. And this is the real images of mathematical activities 500 years ago. Okay, so this is today's images of the classroom I would like to explain today. And this is some references of today, okay? And if you visit this website, you can find not all, but some part of those books, some ideas you can find, okay? What is the lesson study? Okay. At first, I will explain the lesson study. It is reproductive science. And currently, it is well known in the world. Okay. It was begun from the University of Tsukuba. It began, the lesson study began in 1873, okay, more than 100 years ago. Lesson studies originated in Japan, in the University of Tsukuba, more than 100 years ago. And you see that this is a national level lesson study. Students are engaging in the experiment in science, and other teachers are observing. Okay, there are so many teachers are observing. This is the top view. Okay. When we explain the classroom activities, in German didactics, they usually discuss about the dots, triangles, teachers, children, and subject matter. And subject matters are usually recognized theory of mathematics. However, just mathematics, it is not the subject matter, because we are teaching, there is the objective of the teaching. And the children engaging in the activities of learning. On that situation, theory of mathematics is not the theory of mathematics. Subject matter, when we say subject matter, there is the objective of teaching. So if the objective of teaching is embedded, the theory of mathematics, we can call it subject matter. Okay? Without objective, we cannot say the subject matter. And about there is a teaching activities and children's learning activities in relation to the subject matter. And the participating teachers are observing that activities. Okay? And participating teachers usually considering their theories. Theories of education, when we say theory of education, so many people believe that it is produced in the office in the university. However, in the case of lesson study, theories of education are produced by the participating teachers, including the researchers, of course. However, theorization is done in the process of the lesson study, okay? And the lesson study is usually done for produce better practice. And if we have the good theory, it works for reproduce the good classroom, okay? What is a good theory here? Normally, we try to theorize pedagogical content knowledge. Okay? We theorize the pedagogical content knowledge for explaining and using the theories for reproduce better practice. Okay? Okay. From now, I will explain how the societies are changing, and I would like to focus on 21st century skills, because for explaining the necessities to develop mathematical thinking, at first we should know how the societies are changing. Okay, today we call this society, knowledge-based society. On the knowledge-based society, what kind of the teaching content are much more important? Okay, even if we teach the same content, we have to embed the new objective. On that viewpoint, please look at this picture, diagram. Okay? When we this is the result of the OECD research in 2013 about 21st century skills. And this graph compared with 1980 and 2007. Okay? When we compare with 1980s, there are several differences of the employment. Okay? This is a total service, and this is total manufacturing. Okay? We recognize that total manufacturing is decreasing, and total service are increasing. However, even if the area of the service, the content sectors, industrial sectors are not the same. Okay, total service and finance, insurance and real estate and business service, community, social and personal service and communication service. Okay, if we compare with those, the sectors in total service, the finance and insurance and estate, real estate and business services are increasing. Those services are deeply related with mathematics. Okay? And this is a report from in the Wall Street Journal. Okay, Wall Street Journal. And it says that the best 10 jobs, 10 best jobs of the year 2014, please. This is the 10 best job. First, mathematician. Oh, yeah, mathematician. And third, statistician. Third, statistician. And fourth, actuary. And seventh, software engineer. And eighth, computer system analysis. Okay? If you saw those rankings, you will recognize that how mathematics is important for getting a job today. But this is a case of United States. It is not as same as every country. However, previous slide, jobs are changing every year. Okay? Job rate are changing every year. And now mathematical job is getting important more and more. Okay. Why? This slide is in Japanese, but similar ideas are written on a national document, okay? Because we shared global issues for the reform of mathematics education and general education. And this diagram explains general education, 21st century skills. And this is published from NIER, National Institute of Educational Research in Japan. Largest circle explains that practice, okay, ability of the practice, or competency of practice. And the second circle represents ability of thinking. Okay? And third circle is basic ability, such as language literacy, mathematical literacy, and informatics literacy. And the informatics literacy and the mathematical literacy is related with mathematics, of course. So, 21st century skills, mathematics is a major component. However, it is not just meaning of mathematics. It will be the thinking abilities, and it is mainly 21st century skills means the activities or practical skills or practical knowledge. Okay? So mathematics should be useful in our practice. Okay? That is images of the 21st century skills. From this viewpoint, let's think about the objective of mathematics education. Okay? Okay, as firstly I mentioned, we would like to develop the student who will think by themselves and who will use their knowledge and who will apply that knowledge to their reading. Okay? From that viewpoint, of course, knowledge and skills are important. And skills for learning, learning skills are important. Okay? And the largest point is human character formation. Those frameworks are not only limited in mathematics education. Those ideas, those objective framework of the aims of education can be applied in any subject. Firstly, as a part of education, we have to develop human character. Okay? And we would like to develop learning skill. Okay? And we want to develop knowledge and skills. Okay? And when we say knowledge, this is deeply related with mathematics, content of mathematics. However, as I mentioned, what is important in education is that when we say subject matter, it will be included the objective. Objective is related with human character formation and skills for learning. This is the case of mathematics. Okay, traditional ways of calculation, new ways of calculation, pattern on the calculation. Okay, this kind of things. This kind of things are related with knowledge of math. Okay. On the other hand, mathematical thinking. Mathematical thinking is skills for learning. Okay, extension, generalization, anticipation, integration, change the representation for explaining. Change the representation for explaining. Can you imagine? What is it? If you give us the good example, you don't need to discuss or listen to my lecture because you already know. And these kind of things are written in your master document. Okay? However, if you cannot show us a good example, this lecture must be useful. And another important point is that human character formation. This is most important on the knowledge-based society. And it includes the attitude and the values, mathematical attitude and mathematical values. What is it? Okay. Such as beautifulness. When you teach math, do you have the opportunity to say, beautiful? How beautiful? Do you have a chance to say it? And curiosity, reasonableness, and appreciation. What is appreciation in your teaching? What do you appreciate? We plan the time for the appreciation. Okay. I will give you the example from now. But what is clear here is that knowledge and skills can be teach from the result. Okay? If you know the idea of math, you can talk from the beginning. However, if you want to develop children's skills for learning and human character, we have to give children and students to experience the skills of learning and the values of learning, okay? Such as we have to have the opportunities children, we have to give the children the opportunity to think mathematically and to feel the beautifulness of mathematics. Okay, such a thing. Okay, from now I will give you the example, but I don't say many things. I would like to ask you to think by yourself. Okay, because this is a time to think about how to develop math in the classroom, in your classroom. For that, for thinking about how to develop mathematical thinking in classroom, at first, please experience by yourself. While I'm talking, did you get the answer already? My task given to you is 37 times 3. Okay? How much is it? Okay? Okay, if you get the answer, what do you want to do next? This is the most important question to develop mathematical thinking. If your student can answer this question, student already have some mindset. They already know what is mathematics, what is the nature of mathematics. They can produce the idea by themselves. But it is not easy, okay? So at first, we want to give the student the opportunity to think mathematically. So in any case, what do you want to do next? We would like to ask student, what do you want to do next? Okay? Oh. I'll give then the 37 times 6. Now, you can get some idea. If I give 37 times 3, in my experience, there are several answers. Several answers are acceptable. Any answers are acceptable. Because this is open question. Open. What is good of the open question is that through the open question, we can have the opportunity to listen student ideas, okay? And then I will give you the 37 times 6, okay, 37 times 6. If I give the 37 times 6, now you find some idea. If you find some ideas, you may recognize what shall you do next. Okay? Even if you do not have, no problem. We can continue. Okay? And in my case, I usually said 37 times 3, it is 111. 111. In Japan, one is the sound of one is as same as dog bowing. In Japan, dog bow, one. So 111 means doggy number for Japanese. Okay? It is interesting, doggy number 111. How about 2? Okay? 37 times 6 is 222, and then 222 is very much interesting number because 2 is in Japanese likely kissing. Okay? So 2 is lovely number. Okay? From doggy number 111, we find the lovely number 222. Okay? If I say something like this, then, aha, 111, 222. Now you may find some context. Okay? Yes, 333. Okay? Even if student cannot imagine 333, if you can show the 333 like this with blanket, children can easily put the number in 9. Okay? And just if we continue the same question, what do you want to do next? Okay? 37 times 9. 27 equal 999. Okay. Aha, you already find the sum sequence. Okay. This is not the difficult task. How do you explain? Representing by the arrow is very important. Okay. For explaining the relationship between the mathematical sentence or mathematical expression or mathematical or equation, okay? If you write the arrows, it explains the relations. Okay. And it is interesting, but yes, it is interesting. However, if you are good mental calculation, if you are good mental calculator, you stop 999. And I would like to say here, what do you want to do next? Okay. Even if you do not want to think the next step, you will begin the other thing. Okay. Is it then? What do you want to do next? I will say. Then, shall we continue? If a student says something like this, it is fine. Then we will continue. 37 times 13. Okay. 37 times 33. Aha. Okay. On this sequence, if we add 3, the answers increase 111. Okay. And then next 1332. This is the case of 336. Okay. And then 1443. Okay. While putting the number in here, do you find something? Okay. Sorry, I already told many things. Basically, I don't tell like this. Because of this is a lecture, I explain. But normally in the class, I only said, what do you want to do next? Okay. If I say, what do you want to do next? If they recognize the context, they just continue. Through the continuation, they find another pattern. Okay. If you find another pattern, if your student find another pattern, what do you say? Could you describe your pattern? Could you write down the pattern in the sentence? You say, ask something like that. Okay. This is very much important. Okay. And what did you get it? And how did you get it? Okay. What kind of pattern you got? And how did you get the answers? There are two ways of the calculation. First way is that add 3 and add 111. Another calculation is that calculate this answer, this calculation by the vertical form. Okay. Multiplication in vertical form. Okay. And there, I just show you the behind the calculation. Okay. Add one. And 3 times. Okay. 37 times 3. This is 111. Times 10 equal 1110. Yes. 37 times 3 times 11. This is 37 times 3. This part of 111. It is 111 times 11 is this number. Okay, this is other ways of reasoning. 37 times 3. Okay. This is 111 times 11. Oh, no, 12. Okay. 12. Then we get this answer. 37 times. Times 3, this is 111. Okay? And what number comes in here? 13. From the 13, can you imagine this number? Okay. On the normal class, I do not explain like this. Okay, this is a presentation, so I talked by myself. But this kind of thing should be explained by student. And your student can, of course, if they studied the multiplication already. Okay? And then, what do shall we do? Okay. 37 times 42, it is the next calculation. It is 37 times 3 times 14. Okay. 3 times 14 is 42. Is it okay? Okay. Then 37 times 3, 7 times 3 is 111. 111 times 40. Can you imagine the answer? Okay. One is coming. If you know the pattern, one is coming. What? Four is coming here. Okay. Then, five. Can you imagine the relationship? I will show it once more. Okay. 14. If the answer is 14, what is the answer? 37 times 3 times 14, what is the answer? Okay. In the case of 37 times 33, it is 37 times 3 times 11. In this case, 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 1. The case of 33 times 3 times 12, okay, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 3. Okay. Then this case, 1, 4, 5, 5. Yeah. It is very much strange. Okay. Oh, sorry. I should change this part. Oh, it is okay. It is okay. Sorry. Okay. This is very much strange ideas. Right? Strange. What? Very much strange idea. And this idea is defined by Chilean professor. When I show this class, I have also chance to show this class to the Chilean professor. And I find a different pattern, okay, such as add 111 every time, add 111. Okay? But this idea is very much strange. And at that time, Chilean professor said, it is very much strange, but he find this pattern, and he cannot explain. And then we discuss each other. Can you explain why? Until we can explain our feeling of the strange remaining. It is not feel good. If you like math, this strange feeling is not feel good feeling. It just feels strange. So we wanna explain. If we can explain, it is reasonable. Okay? It is understandable. Okay. What shall we do? Okay, what shall we do here? We just want to explain. Until explanation, feeling bad and sick. Okay. If you have the good mind as well as mathematician, you feel bad or sick if you recognize such a strange pattern. Okay. So we want to explain. 111. Oh, this is yes, 37 times 3, 111. Uh-huh. What? 111 times 40? Mm-hmm. Oh, yes, yes, yes. 111 times 4, 4, 4, 4, 4, yes. Then 1, 1, 1, yes. Okay. Then, oh, 4, 4 plus 1 is 5, 4 plus 1 is 5, and 1, 1. Okay. Now we get these answers. Okay, if by the using of the multiplication of the vertical form, we feel these ideas are reasonable. And what is interesting is that 14 cannot divide into 1004. However, if we recognize this number 14, we can divide 1 and 4. Yes, yes. And we can, if we recognize this number 14, we can add 1 plus 4 is 5. Okay? So we are not thinking about the base 10 system. We just think about the ways of writing. Okay? And this multiplication algorithm is also likely discussing about the ways of representation of the algorithm, special ways of representing the algorithm. Okay? 414, 414, 414. Here I don't say 4 times 10, 40, 4 times 100, 400. I didn't say need this vertical form like that. So I'm not thinking about base 10 system. I just thinking about the addition algorithm, multiplication and addition algorithm in a vertical form. So this vertical form will explain these ways of the calculation. Okay? So we feel the reasonableness. This is explaining this activity. Okay? If we did this 111 times 14, not the easy thing. Actually, I cannot calculate in mass mentally. So I cannot get the answers 111 times 4 equal 444. It is not easy because this is not 10, 1. This is 11. It's not easy to think like that. In the case of algorithm, we don't say this is, it's just 4. Okay? 4 plus 1 is 5. We don't say 400 and 100, addition of 400 and addition of 100, 400 plus 100 equal 500. We don't read like that. We are just reading the digit here. Okay. Then, we have a reasonableness. It is how reasonable it is. Okay. And until understanding and explanation feeling, we feel sick. Our feeling is not good. Okay. But if we understand, we feel good, happy. Okay. Okay. Then, Then, what shall I say here? What do you want to do next? Okay, I will continue. There are, of course, many possibilities. We can extend this pattern more. And we can adapt this idea here. Okay, for example, here, okay, 37 times 3 times 14. Okay, this is 1 comes here, 4 comes here, and 1 plus 4 comes here. Okay? In this case, if we try to adapt this idea here, we should see the number 9, 0, 9, because 10th place is nothing. Okay? Here, 10th place is nothing. So we can say this 0, 9. So 0 comes to the 1000th place, and 9 comes to the 1th place. And if we add 0 plus 9, it comes here. So this pattern can be applied to this pattern also. Okay, so we can generalize this idea, other cases. So we have other possibilities to think. Okay? Then I'll give you this task. Okay, at first, this is 10,500. Oh, no, sorry. This number is, sorry. I'll back. Okay, then I'll give you this task. Okay. This number is 15,873 times 7. What do you want to do next? Of course, you calculate. And if you calculate, you get the answers 111111. Okay. And for these activities, Okay, then I will give you the next task. Next task is this one. What do you want to do next? Okay. And after these activities, okay, after these activities, I usually give another task. And nothing talk, and I just observing the student. Okay? And I usually ask if the student did not begin the calculation. If student do not begin the calculation, I just wanna say, shall I have to say something? Okay? And until previous discussion, I continuously say what you want to do next. Okay. So even if I do not say what do you want to do next here, if I do not say what you want to do next here, student can think by themselves normally. And if a student cannot say that word by themselves, I just say, shall I have to say something? Okay. So they can imagine. And if students say, no, please do not support us, if students say something like this, I'm succeeding the previous class. Because if student find 111111, student can imagine the set of activities, okay? So it means that student develop their own mathematical thinking, okay? Student can learn by themselves now, okay? If student can say we can, very good, okay? Then I just wanna say that if student, what do you want to do next is that we are asking the student to imagine the future, and we want to develop the ability to think, to imagine the future. It is not only limited in mathematics, okay? It is related with the necessary abilities on the knowledge-based societies, okay? This is 21st century skills. Okay. From now, I would like to reflect on the activities. What do you learn from this experience? Please write down on your notebook what you learn from this example. Okay? It is related with that. When you use this example in your class, what do you want to teach from this example, using this example? Okay? If you have clear objective of teaching, you can imagine how you run the class. If you do not have the good objective, You just begin to teach from the result. It is much faster. However, they cannot develop the ways of thinking. We cannot develop mathematical thinking, and we cannot develop the attitude and the values of, okay, of, we cannot develop human character. Okay? So, you already wrote something, right? You already wrote something on the notebook, right? Then I, this is my one of the, my answers, okay? Student can study the pattern of calculation, okay? Student can study the process of generalization. How can we generalize the ideas, okay? Through the only the discussion of the, what do you want to do next, student begin to think other cases, okay? And at the same time, why I said the doggy number and lovely numbers? We have to say, I have to say it because I want to teach beautifulness. Okay? We have to characterize the beautifulness by the terms of doggy numbers and lovely numbers. And at the same time, strange calculation is also very much important. If we feel strange, we, it means that mathematics is a reasonable subject. If students do not believe mathematics is a reasonable subject, students do not feel strange. Okay, so even if students do not say strange, I would like to say strange, really. Okay, such a terms are important. If I say really or strange, students have to explain. Then they recognize the reasonableness. Okay, and after that, we should name again. Beautifulness and reasonableness on the process of the reflection. So, okay, and in the mathematical explanation, okay, I just back, okay, beautifulness and reasonableness, okay. And when we explain mathematics, we usually ask student why. Okay? Normally, the student reply the procedure because teacher only teach procedure. If teacher only teach procedure, if student answers to answer the procedure. Okay? However, we want to develop student who will explain the reason why. Okay, reason why, and another thing is aims of or objective and values. Okay, why you would like to think like that? That is related with aims, objective, and values. Because I feel beautiful. You said lovely number, then I will continue. Okay, this is the values. And if we say that if student can explain the reason by the multiplication in vertical form, they are explaining the reason using the different representation. Okay. Okay, I will back to the objective of math education. On this example, can you apply those terms? Okay. If you can apply those terms, now you will understand the meaning. And you can imagine how you can teach it, how you teach it. Okay. You can imagine how you teach it. And my major strategy is what do you want to do next? Okay, I just want to try to listen to student ideas and give my ideas little bit, okay, on that sequence. And on that sequence, I give some naming, because for the reflecting on the activities, without naming, we cannot easily back. And especially in the case of Japan, we do not erase the blackboard. Every discussions are written on the blackboard, and we do not erase. The reason why we do not erase the blackboard is that if we erase, we cannot reflect on that activity. For reflecting on, we remain the process of the discussion on the blackboard. And at the same time, we give some naming as for the flag for the reflecting on. If I say doggy number or lovely number, we can back. And if we remain the strange, how strange, on the board, we can back. Okay. Likely cartoon, we can put to the our feeling and our thinking on the blackboard also. Okay. Okay. Conclusion. Okay. Mathematical thinking can be developed through the reflection and appreciation. And the lesson plan is important. However, the planning of the lesson means embedding the objective. Okay. If we don't have clear objective, we think that it is easier to teach from the conclusion. Okay. If we teach mathematical thinking and we develop the values of mathematics and the mindset or attitude, we have to have the process and we have to have the opportunity to reflect on and appreciation. Okay. And in our book, Isoda and Katagiri, there is a list of mathematical thinking. And it is including the mindset. Okay. Okay, so if further discussion can be seen on the web or the book of mathematical thinking. This is my reference, okay? If you go to this website, you can find those books, okay? Not all, some part, okay? And if you so read these books, you will understand more deeply about how to develop mathematical thinking in the classroom. So thank you very much.